Many people who would love your problem because your problem is someone else's fantasy dream come true. It really is. You might think, no, I promise you it is. And I am thrilled to be here and thrilled to talk to you all and always thrilled to help people. And I spent 33 years studying human behavior. And people think that human behavior is very complex, but it really isn't. It's actually very, very simple. And one of the things that will help you to understand why we get so anxious when we're in change is that we are wired to react much more to loss than to change. So I'm going to spend half an hour talking about your wiring, why you do what you do. And when you know why you do what you do, then you can do what you want to do, not what you do do. So I'm going to take you through a lot of stuff. I'm going to almost condense 30 years of human behavior into 30 minutes. And that's okay, because you just have to know some very simple things. So let's talk about your mind. We're in a place in the world now where there's so much uncertainty. I know that. I left America on June the 20th for a month. And discovered that after I got to London, I can't actually get back into America, and no one knows when I can go back. They're saying maybe December, even though I have a visa and a work permit. So there's a lot of uncertainty. I've left my house, my cats, my house has been flooded while I'm here. All kinds of stuff has gone on. So I've got a lot of uncertainty, and human beings have an important need. Here it is. We need certainty. That is a human need. I need certainty. Well, how can I have it when my house is flooded? I don't know when I can go back to America. My daughter's dad just died, and there's all kinds of stuff going on. But in the midst of all of that, it all comes down to how you dialogue with you, the way you feel about everything, the virus, your job, your relationship, your body, your health, your emotional well-being is down to two things, only two: the pictures you make in your head and the words you say to yourself. So my picture is, look, I'll get back to America eventually. My house is flooded, but hey, I'm going to get a brand new house. They're going to redo everything. So I'm sort of chewing through that, and it's not really affecting me. Certainty. 9/11, the AIDS epidemic. There's so many times in human history where something's coming, oh my God, there's no certainty. After 9/11, there were no planes in the sky, all the shops shut. After the SARS virus, it was the same. I lived in the 80s in the AIDS epidemic. And it was kind of terrifying, because they say things like, well, you know, people are going to die and I'll never be the same again and nobody can date again. And then we kind of realized, actually, people are not dying, they're surviving, and we are still dating. After 9/11, nothing will ever be the same again, but it kind of was. So in an uncertain world, what do you have to do? You have to give yourself certainty. And I can hear you saying, yeah, but how do I give myself certainty? I don't know if I've got a job to go back to, not sure I can pay my bills, haven't seen my partner for 3 months because of quarantine, or I've seen them every day. I don't even want to be with them anymore because I've been cooped up like a chicken and now I'm questioning if I should even be with this person. So how do you give yourself certainty in a very uncertain world? Well, you talk to yourself differently. You say things like, this will pass. What's good about this? Is there anything here that could benefit me? Will I look back in 5 years and see this as a terrible thing or just a blip? So the first thing you must do is give yourself certainty. I'm the same. I'm the same person. My job's the same. My kids are the same. I'm the same and I can be the same. And a lot of us have found going through lockdown that there was actually was quite a lot that was good about it. And we got to realize that relationships are the most important thing and that being with people is the most important thing. So the first thing is, whatever you do, give yourself certainty. I will be okay. This too will pass. What's good about this? What's great about this? What's useful about this? Well, one of the things is we have time. I just don't have time. If I had time, I'd go to the gym. I'd have a hot body. My house would be immaculate. I'd write a book. My website would be amazing. If I had time, you think, do you know what? I've got all the time. I'm not working on that website. My house is no tidier. my body is the same. So actually, maybe it wasn't the time. Maybe it was me. Maybe I was just procrastinating because of a fear of rejection. You know, when we procrastinate, when we sabotage, when we self-destruct, it's because we're scared of not being enough. So here's a second way to give yourself certainty. The first way is talk to yourself better. This will pass. I will find something good in this, no matter what it is. I will be okay. I'm still the same person. I can create certainty in my life. The second thing that will give you certainty throughout your life is to say, I am enough. It sounds so simple. It is simple. Its strength is in its simplicity. I'm good enough. I'm smart enough. I'm lovable enough. I'm attractive enough. I'm worthy enough. I'm interesting enough. I don't care what you put in front of the words, I am enough. But the words that follow I am, follow you. The words that go after I am, go after you. I am not good enough. I am terrible at confrontation. I am insecure. I am self-conscious. Stop all of that. Stop it now and say, I am enough. I am good enough. I am lovable enough. I'm smart enough. I'm interesting enough. I am enough. And when you start to tell yourself you're enough, all the things that block you, which tend not to be circumstances, but you, your fear of failing, your fear of not being enough, or what causes procrastination and self-sabotage. So when you can say every day, I'm enough, just the way I am, that doesn't mean you think, well, if I'm enough, I can just lie on the sofa all day and eat cake. No, when you know you're enough, you think, well, if I'm enough, I'm worth a promotion. I'm worth this relationship getting better. I'm worth taking care of myself because I'm enough. You must start your day saying I'm enough and join the I'm Enough Club right now. If you come to my house, it's on every mirror. It's on my fridge in magnets. You might notice that I have these little wristbands that say I'm enough. I have one on this hand too. I have it everywhere. I have it on t-shirts, on sweatshirts, on cushions. There's so many places in my house where I have enough. All my passwords have I'm enough in them securely, of course. So every day I have to type I'm enough. I have to type it, read it, write it, speak it, say it. And it has changed my entire life. It's changed the life of so many clients. People write to me from schools and go, wow, you know, we went on board with this I'm Enough program and bullying has stopped. That's extraordinary. My kid was a bully or was being bullied. My husband said to me, gosh, you know what? You don't shout at the kids anymore. What's happened? I don't know. Somehow I feel enough. So you've already got two strategies. Give yourself the certainty by looking for what's good about any situation, anything at all. The only way you can ever, ever, ever feel good about change is if you can control the direction of change in your life and make it change for the better. Change is inevitable. The minute you're born, you're changing. And we're scared of change in case we're worse off. And someone say, oh, you know, I hate getting old. I'm like, well, it's better than the alternative. Everything's going south. Well, it's better than the alternative. Get old or not get old. My kids are driving me crazy. There are people who have spent all their money on IVF who would love a kid to drive them crazy. You see, a couple of things that help all my clients is this. Look at your problem and realize that there's someone in the world who would swap places with you tomorrow. You have a kid that drives you crazy. You have a partner that leaves their underwear on the floor. Your boss is difficult. Your commute is long and frustrating. I'd love a commute. I'd love a job. I'd love a boss. I'd love a kid. I'd love a partner. I'd swap places with you tomorrow. So first of all, there is many people who would love your problem because your problem is someone else's fantasy dream come true. It really is. You might think, no, I promise you it is. So change. We're scared of change in case the change is change for the worst. And the only way you can ever feel good about change is to make it change for the better. When you can look at the change, go, this is change for the better, then you are in control of the direction of your life. And when you are in control of the direction of your life, you're winning. So in a lockdown, which isn't really lockdown, by the way, no one is locked in, no one is cooped in like a chicken, no one is in prison, no one is, you're not even in quarantine. Quarantine means you're in a place in hospital, they have to come and look at you through a window. You're not really in quarantine. I just flew back to London a month ago. I had to do 2 weeks of quarantine. I had a lovely time. I sat in my garden. I called all my friends. I read lots of books. I caught up on lots of Netflix. I wrote some new programs. I made this thing for children where they're using their immune system. So I had quite a good time, but I had to keep saying, what's good about this change? What's good about not being able to leave the house for 2 weeks? How much have I asked for time to myself? What's great about it? How can I make it good? How can I make it useful? Because the worst thing you can do is go, oh, this is hell. This is a nightmare. This is killing me. This is so boring. I'm losing my mind. I'm just eating and I'm like a train running out of control. I'm eating like a pig. I'm becoming the size of a barn. We say this to ourselves all the time. If you have ever said, I'm eating like a pig, I'm a train wreck, I'm out of control, my legs are the size of a house, you are lying to yourself. If you've ever said, my kid is killing me, my partner drives me crazy, my boss makes me go insane, this job is driving me mad, I'm at the end of my rope, at my maximum, I'm stressed out of my mind, I'm starving, that is a lie. And if you want to lie to yourself, which we all do, tell yourself a better lie. I'm really enjoying this time to myself and finding something good about it. I'm not going to say that I'm enough is a lie because it is the truth about you. But when you say, you might think it's not really true, you know, because I'm not perfect. I don't look like a model. I haven't got the right shape. I haven't got a great job. I haven't got a great car. So you might think it's a lie. I love telling myself a better lie. It's one of the best things I ever did in my entire life. When I go on stage, go, I'm so happy, I love this, which is not actually true. I would feel a little bit nervous, but I'd go, I love it, I love it, I love it. When I was giving birth, I decided to tell myself there was nowhere else I'd rather be, and I was having the time of my life. It's actually very useful because I gave birth really easily. I didn't really feel any pain. When I was writing a book, I decided to say there's nowhere I'd rather be in the entire world than here at this table writing a book, and believe me, that wasn't true. But when I said it enough, it became true. So tell yourself a better lie. I like this. I'm finding something good about it. My life is great. Wake up every morning and go, I love my life. There's a great guy called Neeraj who's got his song, I Love My Life. It's now a Mind Valley anthem. Get that song and play. See, when you wake up and go, I love my life. I love waking up. Hey, it's a great day. I'm here. I've got all this stuff to look forward to. I love my shower. I love my first coffee of the day. I love everything. When you can do that and start to feel great about little things, every day starts to feel like Christmas. And when you can say, I love the change, every change in my life is change for the better. There's something good coming from this. When you can remember, you must take control of the direction of change in your life and make it change for the better. When you can do that, your life is extraordinary. So let me take you to some other things that will help you. We're talking about anxiety, uncertainty, being out of control makes you anxious. The pictures you say to yourself, the pictures you make in your head and the words you say to yourself. Here's a word that will make you anxious. I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous about having to speak to people or give a presentation or talk to someone. And if you say, I'm excited, I'm jazzed, I'm psyched, I'm excited, I'm ready, your mind cannot tell the difference in what is real and what is imagined. And you see, you can choose to say, I'm nervous. You can choose to say, I'm excited. That's your choice. But your body cannot choose. It must act on the words you tell it. So let me prove it to you right now. Just put your hand in front of your mouth like that. Close your eyes. And with your eyes closed, I want you to imagine you're smelling half of a great big fat lemon. You've got in your hand a juicy, wonderful, yummy lemon. Squeeze that lemon. Inhale, and with your eyes shut, breathe in that great lemon smell, because nothing smells as good as a lemon. Squeeze the lemon so the juice comes out and is on the surface of the lemon. Stick out your tongue and lick off those lemon droplets. And now open your mouth and shove that half a lemon in your mouth and start to eat. I want you to eat the lemon, eat the flesh, suck out the juice, swirl it around your mouth, chew every lemon segment. Chew it, bite it, eat it, swirl it around. And while you're telling your mind I'm eating a lemon, while the pictures you have in your head are of eating a lemon, and the thoughts you're thinking are eating a lemon, you'll find that you start to make saliva to a thought. So open your eyes, and here's a question for you. Was there a lemon? Some of you go, nope. Some of you go, yes. In fact, you're both right. No, there wasn't really a lemon, but yes, there was. It was in your head. Your mind didn't go, come on, there's no lemon. This is silly. Your mind went, lemon, acidic, wash away tooth enamel. I need my teeth. After we survived on the planet once by having teeth, we had to have teeth. We couldn't liquidize food. And so when you think you're eating a lemon, that's a threat to your survival. You pump out saliva to wash away the acid. If you can make your mind think you're eating a lemon when it's only in your imagination, you can do everything. So don't say nervous, say excited. Don't say scared, say challenged. Use better words. The words you use shape the quality of your life. And if you don't like your reality, change your words, because your words shape your reality. So how to cope with anxiety is really simple. Give yourself better words. Of course, breathe better. Take deep breaths. Push your shoulders down. If you're anxious and you're like that, push your shoulders down. Fill your mouth up with saliva and so on. And let's do that right now. I want you to imagine you're feeling super anxious. I'm going to give you five things that will stop anxiety in its tracks right now. The first one is to push your shoulders down. You can physically do that. Push them down, right down. Now, fill up your mouth with saliva. That's it. And pump it around. I can't really do it because I'm talking and I'm sort of spitting at the screen or drooling. Fill up your mouth with saliva and swirl it around. Do it more and more, because your mind has a belief a wet mouth means you're relaxed. That's why kissing makes you relaxed. It's why store detectives and immigration officers look for people licking their lips. It's why court lawyers drink water, or people who are going to speak drink water. A wet mouth tells your brain that you are super relaxed, and a dry mouth says you're super tense. Fill up your mouth with saliva again, swirl it around, push your shoulders down. Now let's do something else. I want you to take your hands and push down your arms like this. You might think, oh, this is all silly. Who cares? It works. It's called the havening technique. Push down your arms. Let me see if I can stand up so you can see me doing it. I want you to push like this. You can do it fast. You can do it slow. But that action, if you do that 20 or 30 times, you'll find it deeply, deeply relaxing. And now I want you to put your hands together. And you'll say to me, Marisa, why do you always do that when you're on stage? Because it releases delta brain waves. It's super, super relaxing. Rub your hands together. You can even put them over your eyes, but I just like doing this. And finally, here's an anti-COVID thing, touch your face. Try doing that or that. You see, you have receptors here. When you're super stressed, and you can just touch your face and do that, it instantly relaxes you. And here's one more. Stick out your tongue like this. When you're trying to concentrate or focus, you see children do that. They have a pen and they'll do this. When you put your tongue in between your teeth, it makes you relaxed. You might feel like an idiot, but that doesn't matter. So the way to get rid of anxiety, this, and this, and this, and pushing your shoulders down. But the biggest thing is use different words. You're not anxious, you're excited. You're not nervous, you're excited. You're not losing it, you're in an amazing situation, you're doing well. Uncertainty, well, you know what to do about uncertainty. Give yourself, certainly in an uncertain world, give yourself certainty. By saying, I'm still here, I'm still the same person. It's like people say, well, you know, my partner just dumped me, they left me, they ripped out my heart and jumped all over it. Well, they probably just got a bit more. But you know what? Everything they loved in you is still in you. So you give yourself certainty by going, hey, this person loved me once. They said I was the best thing ever, that I was funny and witty and fascinating and sexy and gorgeous and compelling. And if they saw it in me once, it's still there. They didn't pack it up in their bag when they took their stuff. It's still there. And every compliment you've ever had, think about those. What did your teacher say? Your parents say? Your first boyfriend, girlfriend say? Your best friend say? And if you go, you know what? I never got enough compliments. There is nothing that will grow your self-esteem like praise. I want you right now, this minute. So I'm a big fan of not just listening, but doing it. I want you to think of the words you wanted to hear your whole life. Take a minute right now. You know, this is not rocket science. We want to hear, I'm nice, I'm kind, I matter, people like me, I'm attractive, I'm interesting. So imagine you've got the best parents, the best teacher, the best partner, the best boss, the best friends in the whole world, and they are super qualified to praise you. In fact, they've got a degree in praise. What would they say to you? I'll give you a heads up. They'd say, you're the best. If there was a template ever being the best friend or the best boyfriend or the best girlfriend, it would be you. You're the best kid ever. How lucky am I to be your parent? You're the best kid. If they're a teacher, you're the best kid in my class. Whatever you needed, give it to yourself. Don't wait for someone else to come and go, hey, you're so great. Say it to yourself, say you're enough. That is how you deal with uncertainty. You don't go to the world, hey world, hey, could someone out there tell me I matter? Could you tell me I matter? Could you tell me I'm enough? Could you make me feel good? Sure, I can do that. But in a year, I'm going to dump you and find someone younger, taller, richer. When you give someone else the power to make you feel good, you give them the power to take it away. When you do it yourself, it never leaves you. So the person you're going to spend the longest time with in your entire life is you. You're going to spend the longest time with you. So you better be the best friend to yourself. So let's cover the last one, control. I don't feel like I have control. Well, here's the truth about control. Your thoughts control your feelings. Your feelings control your actions, and your actions control your events. And the law of control begins and ends with your thinking. Let me say that again in case you want to write it down. Your thoughts control your feelings. Your feelings control your actions, and your actions control your events. So let's play a little game. If you woke up every day and you thought to yourself, I'm enough. I'm enough, I matter, I'm significant, and I'm lovable. Let me say that again. In fact, say it with me. Let's imagine you've just woken up and you're going to say out loud, I'm enough, I matter, I'm significant, I'm lovable. I'm enough because I'm enough. I matter because I matter. I'm significant because I'm significant, and I'm lovable. Because I'm lovable. Imagine if you said that every day and it sank in like lip serve on chapped lips. That thought will control your feelings. Well, now I know I'm enough. I can take risks. I can ask people out. I can ask for a job. I can ask for a pay rise. I can ask for more because I think a thought and the feelings are good feelings. And because the feelings are good, I now take actions. I'm braver, more confident, more courageous. I take risks. Your thoughts control your feelings control your actions control your events. And if you make a decision today to start every day with I'm enough, I matter, I'm significant, I'm lovable, your life will change. But just imagine that you wake up and go, well, I'm not enough. I'm not enough at all. I'm not smart enough, pretty enough, interesting, good enough. I'm not enough. Now what feelings do you think you have? Well, I feel terrible because I'm not enough. I might feel really sad. I might feel really angry because I'm not enough. I'm pissed off because I'm not enough. And I'm resentful, irritable, cranky. Or, no, I'm really sad. I'm a bit depressed. I'm a bit down. And if I think that thought, I'm not enough, and I have those feelings, what kind of actions do you think you take? Often none at all, because you can't take a risk when you think those thoughts. You're too scared of being rejected. So if you want control, and certainly in an uncertain world, it goes back all the time to what you think about yourself. So we're going to do a 15-minute meditation right now. It's a perfect time to go into it. And I'm just going to tell you some things about, you know, I have my own meditation called NICE. It means new, innovative. You're going to code in what you want, erase what you don't want, repeat, rewire. So I'm going to be asking you at some stage to touch your forehead and just impress upon yourself what you want. You're going to maybe open out your hands like that. So I need to be a bit closer. And you're going to code in and call in what you want. And then you're going to just move from side to side. And in moving from side to side, you're going to erase what you don't want. You're going to impress upon yourself what you do want. Code in and call in what you want. Move from side to side to erase what you don't want. It's going to be really simple, really fun. It's going to take 15 minutes. We're going to start right now. Now, people get very confused about meditation. I've got to empty my mind. The human mind doesn't really want to be completely emptied, so don't worry about that. All you have to do is sit. I'm a great believer that stillness is a really good thing. So if you wouldn't mind, make yourself comfortable. Make sure your phone's not on. Nothing's going to disturb you. Don't cross your legs. Don't sit like that. It's a very closed position. Uncross your legs. Uncross your arms. Try and sit like that if you can, because it's that kind of meditative receiving position. But it's not super important. Take a deep breath. Breathe in. Close your eyes. And with your eyes closed, just breathe in. And breathe out. That's it. And again, breathe in, breathe out. And remember, there's nowhere for you to go. You are a human being, not a human doing. And for the moment, you're going to just be. Breathe in, breathe out. The first thing you did when you came on this planet was to take a breath. So breathe in. Breathe out. And I want you to practice balance. I want you to give a breath and then take one. So breathe out, and in breathing out, give all that air away. And now take a breath. Take one in, breathe in, take it, take it. That's good. Take some more. Give it away. Let it all go. And then take again. I want you to get very used to giving and taking, receiving, giving, taking, taking. A lot of people are very bad at receiving praise. They can give, oh, you're so great, I love you. And someone says, you are too. They go, oh, no, not really. I want you to get into expansion. You see, when you expand and you give, you have to receive. If someone praises you and says, hey, you did a great job. You go, who, me? Oh, that was a fluke. You're not receiving. So let's just practice giving and receiving. Give a breath away. That's good. Now receive one, take it. But now I want you to just be a giver. I want you to breathe out and keep giving and giving. Give away that breath. That's it. Keep going. Breathe out more. Be a giver. Be one of those spiritual who just gives everything they've got. Give so much away. Give all that breath away. Keep giving. Keep giving. Keep giving. I want you to keep giving until it actually feels uncomfortable. until it feels unnatural, until you realize that you have no balance because you're just giving, give more, give until you really don't like it. And now I want you to take a breath in. What a relief. You're taking a breath back. And I want you to take more. I want you to be a taker, take more and more until you think, oh, I'm so selfish. I'm taking all the air here. Keep taking. Breathe in, take more, take even more, take much more, take so much, don't give. Just keep taking that breath in. Keep taking it until you think, this doesn't feel good. And now give. And now just breathe in and out, give and take, and there is balance. You see, when you give to other people and not to yourself, you don't have balance. You must praise yourself. So as you go deeper, breathe in, breathe out, give and take, receive and give. Understand that you can give and receive. You can give of your talent, give of yourself, give of your time. But you must receive praise, financial reward, all kinds of rewards. And now you have the balance that nature insists on. You give and receive. You receive and give and you give. Yourself praise. You think of all the words you'd love to have heard said about you in your lifetime, and it's never too late to go back and say you're a great kid, you're a great person. Look at you. You're so smart. You're so beautiful. You matter. You have something amazing to offer the world. So still, breathing in and breathing out, take the first two fingers of your hand. I want you to press the area just in between your eyes at the top of your nose, and I want you to make a little circle. Press, and I want you to impress upon yourself the praise you have always wanted to have. And you can do it out loud, or you can just do it in your head. I'm a great person. I'm lovable. I matter. I'm significant. Repeat after me. Keep pressing and repeat. I matter. I'm significant. I'm lovable. I'm enough. I'm here for a purpose. I have something important to offer the world. And I'm going to give you a minute or two. No, I'm not speaking, but I want you to really impress upon your mind what it is that you want to feel. I want you to press and impress. Impress, instruct, install into your mind that you wish to feel calm and focused and positive and happy and self-assured and self-trusting. But now I want you to pick your own words. You know what it is that you really want to feel and be and do and achieve. So right now, just say it. I'm impressing upon myself that I am. Remember the words that follow I am, follow you. I am super smart, if you like. I am incredible at making relationship. I don't mind what you say, but I want you to take that time and right now say some I ams and make sure the words that followed I am, the I am, super positive. Just do that right now. And if you're not sure, just keep saying I'm enough, I'm lovable, I'm worthy, I'm significant, I'm important, because that is enough. Breathe in and out a bit more. Now I want you to open your hands in this position. Sorry, keep your eyes closed. Just open your hands into that yoga position. And I want you to code in and call in what it is that you most wish to receive in your life. Is it love? Is it success? Is it peace, joy, bliss? Wonderful health, a stellar career, financial freedom, whatever you wish for. Code it in, call it in. Tell the universe, tell your mind, tell yourself what it is that you want so much. And do it like this, not, oh, I dream of, or I wish for, I hope for. I want you to say, I am coding into my life right now financial freedom. I'm coding in and calling in abundant love. I'm coding in, calling in, wiring in, firing in confidence, self-esteem, love, health, success, whatever it is. Code in and call in. I want you to say, I code in, call in, and insist on X, X, X. Do that now. And let's do it one more time. What I require for myself, what I insist on for myself, what I give to myself, what I'm coding in and calling in is filling the blank. And do that again with an even more compelling voice. What I code in, call in, insist on, give to myself, require of myself is, do it now. And just one more time. You see, mindset means the way you talk to yourself. People get very confused with what is mindset. Mindset is how you talk to you. One more time. Take the mindset of coding in and calling in what you want. Use powerful words in the present tense. What I code in, call in, insist on, require of, and give to myself is fill in the blanks. And now I want you to just move your shoulders from side to side. And as you move your shoulders from side to side, you are erasing, eradicating, eliminating, releasing uncertainty. Everything that could have held you back is becoming erased, eradicated, eliminated. It is long gone. It is out of your life. It's in the past. It's all behind you. Sway from side to side, and as you sway, you're erasing, eliminating, eradicating, releasing anything that could have or would have got in your way. You are erasing, eradicating, eliminating, and releasing stress. You're erasing blocks. And as you erase, eradicate, eliminate, shatter, and smash uncertainty, in its place, you have certainty. You now have unshakable steps to have an unshakable mindset. You dialogue with yourself in a wonderful way. You use powerful words. You remember the way you feel about everything is down to the pictures you make in your head and the words you say to yourself. You now use positive, powerful words. So just let yourself go deeper. Just go deeper into this mindset. You use the word exciting rather than something negative. You give yourself certainty. In an uncertain world, you are certain that you are lovable, you matter, you're significant, you're here with something incredible to offer the world. So you give yourself the certainty you need. You understand that when you think you have no control, that isn't true, because you control your thoughts. You control your thoughts, they control your feelings, they control your actions. So as long as you're controlling your thoughts and making them positive, you are in control. You have certainty. You're calm and purposeful. You have direction. You know with unshakable conviction that you are lovable, you are enough, you matter, you're deeply. deeply significant. You are here with something amazing to offer the world, and you have a gift that you can monetize. You're here for a reason. There's no one else exactly like you. So you now have strategies. You have strategies to give yourself an incredible mindset. You know that you matter. You know that you are lovable. So just allow yourself to go deeper and deeper. For just another minute to do, just go even deeper still. That's good. And in a minute, you can open your eyes, but just take another minute. Just take another 2 or 3 minutes to understand that you now have strategies. You have true resilience because you know you're enough. You know how to control your thoughts. You know how to control your feelings. You know how to feel good about yourself. You know how to give yourself the praise you've wanted your whole life. And you don't give that to anyone else because no one can do a better job than you of knowing how lovable you are. If you give someone else that job, they may get bored with it, but you falling in love with yourself is a lifelong romance. It never bores you. The longest relationship you'll ever have in your whole life is with you. And today, right now, you're falling in love with you, praising you, building up you, being resilient you, with a phenomenal mindset, a mindset where you are calm and strong. And always in control, because you control what you think. You control what you think about you. What you think about you is that you're kind of amazing and awesome and phenomenal. You know, if your life rewound 500 years, you'd be the king or the queen with all that you know. If you went back in time, you'd be the king, you'd be the emperor, you'd be the queen just because of what you know.